Hello, Yogita here. So today we are going to learn how to add up a product in high-tech billing software. So basically, the screen which you can see right now is known as dashboard. We have to go to master to add a product. Masters, the very first option which comes in is add a product. Click on it. This is the tab which is going to be open. Now you see this red asterisk sign, this symbolizes that these are all the mandatory columns which we need to fill to add a product. Other than that, these are the optional items which are there. So I am assuming that I have a general store or a supermarket and I am adding a product. So I have already categorized my product as biscuits, packed food, dairy and chips. So let's take chips as my group and I'll take a brand name Lay's. Now item code is something to categorize more briefly. So if you want to do that, that is optional. You can enter some item code. It could be alphanumeric, or if you do not want to do it, it's up to you. So I am guessing it is a Lay's packet of maybe 5 rupees, so it has 25 grams in it and it is sweet and salty. All right, now the second option which we see here is price detail. So there are two options which are mandatory. First one says purchase price, second one says sales price. In purchase price, I'm guessing we have bought it in 4 rupees and I'm selling it in 5 rupees. There are two more options which says minimum sale price and MRP. Both are optional. So if the product has it, you can type it out or else leave the option. In the third option, you see it says stock and unit details. As I've already mentioned, we have packets here. So I will select packet accordingly. If someone has a milk bottle or anything else in unit, they can change it from here. We have multiple options here. So all right, in opening stock is something that we already have a product and then we are adding it up. So I am assuming that I have an opening stock of 10 chips. I have 10 chips packet with me right now. Opening stock value would be calculated automatically, so you don't need to calculate it. The fourth option which we see here is GST details. If the item or product already has HSN and SAC code, you can enable that. And if it has a GST rate and you want them to be added here, you can manually write them out or else it would be zero. Now, if on the same product there is a discount which you want to add, you can write it in digit and it would be applicable. Then we see here the option of low level limit. As we have already assumed that the opening stock which we have right now is 10, and then the low level limit I am putting as 2. So when my stock has only 2 chips left, I could see a report in which I could see that, okay, now the chip packets are out of stock and I need to reload it. So it is for that use. We see the product type. There are 3 types in here: general, apparel and footwear. So according to your business category, we can select. Then if the product has a barcode or you are billing it with the help of barcode, you can enter it here. Then product description. If for the same product there is a description which I wanted to be printed in my invoice, I will mention it here. If that same description is something which I want in my invoice also, so I'll enable this option. If I know that this product, I am selling it 20 times a day, so I'll click it as one click sale and I'll make frequent bill, a very quick billing procedure. For enable tracking, this is something if you want to track an item. Then we have print barcode. The barcode which you have entered here, you want that to be print in your invoice, you can enable this. Not for sale is something if the product is for future sale or not for current sale, you can mark it for not for sale so that nobody can make a bill on it. That is it. This is the only procedure which we need to do to add up a product. Click on save button. That's it. So while I've already added 3-4 products from the same tab, now I wanted to see how many products have I added right now, or I want to edit the product. What I need to do is I'll go to master again. The third option which you see right now, search and manage item, click there. Now there's a list of items which I have added. By clicking on the item, view details will help me to update and modify my item. delete is, and the second thing which you see here is delete. Whichever list, whichever item you have added and it is shown in the list, you can delete it from here. And that's it for today's video. We'll be back with a new tutorial. Thank you for joining in. Good day ahead.